G'day, Paul here, down by the Sunshine Coast University Hospital, and I'm sitting up on the gardens, in the gardens, by this lovely statue they've got there, made out of solid steel, beautiful piece of work, of a young boy standing on his hands. And I remember doing that myself when I was about his age. Hallelujah. But at 76 years of age, all I can say is, where did they go? They went so fast. I went to a friend's funeral last week, and that's happening more and more as I get older. More and more of my friends and colleagues are passing and going into eternity. So I thought I would just share a few scriptures about how quickly our lives pass us by. Psalm 39 verse 4 says, "Show me, Lord, my life's end and the number of my days. Let me know how fleeting my life is." I already know that it's fleeting. "You have made my days a mere hand breadth. The span of my years is nothing before you. Everyone is but a breath, even those who seem secure. Surely everyone goes around like mere phantom. In vain they rush about, heaping up their wealth without knowing whose it will finally be. But now, Lord, what do I look for? My hope is in you. Save me from all my transgressions." That's a beautiful way to end that little bit of scripture. He's looking to the Lord and asking him, "Save me from my transgressions." You know, even in our old age, we can still get things wrong and make transgressions. In Psalm 90, the psalmist says, "Teach us to number our days that we may gain a heart of wisdom. May the favour of the Lord our God rest on us. Establish the work of our hands for us." Yes, establish the work of our hands. We've only got a few days on this earth, and we ask the Lord to help us do what he wants us to do, whether it be to be a fine musician or an electrician or a policeman or whatever. Ask the Lord to guide you so that you are in the will of God for your life. In James 4 he says, "Why? You do not even know what will happen tomorrow. What is your life? You are a mist that appears for a little while and then vanishes." Here as a mist for a little while and then it's gone. In Job he says, "My days are swifter than a weaver's shuttle." In Job 8 he says, "For we are born only yesterday and know nothing, and our days on earth are but a shadow." Job 9:25, he says, "My days are swifter than a runner. They fly away without a glimpse of joy. They skim past like boats of papyrus, like eagles swooping down on their prey." We are here for such a short time. And there's more scriptures about it. In Job 14, he said, "They spring up like flowers and wither away. Shadows, they do not endure and come to an end without hope." In Psalm 144, he says, "They are like a breath. Their days are like a fleeting shadow." And in Isaiah 40, verse 6, it says, "A voice says, cry out. And I said, what shall I cry? All people are like grass, and all their faithfulness is like the flowers of the field. The grass withers and the flowers fall because the breath of the Lord blows on them. Surely the people are grass. The grass withers and the flowers fall, but the word of our God endures forever." That we may pass away, but the word of God endures forever. Then in Psalm 78 he says, "He remembered that they were but flesh, a passing breeze that does not return." And we're gone. In 1 Chronicles 29:15 it says, "Our days on earth are like a shadow without hope." In 1 Peter 1:24 he says, "For all people are like grass, and all the glory is like the flowers of the field. The grass withers and the flowers fall, but the word of the Lord endures forever." We're not here forever, but the word of the Lord is. And in Psalm 102 he says, "My days are like the evening shadow. I wither away like grass, but you, Lord, sit enthroned forever. Your renown endures through all generations. And thank you, Jesus, that you've given us your word. You are the word. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. Jesus, you are the word. We're so grateful to know you, to have you, and to have you guide us and give us your spirit and to lead us into all truth. Thank you, Jesus. And for all you listeners and watchers out there, God bless you. Know that your days are numbered and look to the Lord for eternal salvation. You get into the Word and let the Word of God get into you. See you later now. Goodbye.